Hello everybody, welcome back to another video, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use the clone command. It's a very, well, tricky command to use in Minecraft because you don't want to get it wrong because then, well, everything in your world could mess up, right? So let me show you how it works. First, the normal clone command, and then I'll show you some extra stuff you can do with the clone command, which is actually pretty helpful, some of them. So first of all, I'm going to show you how to do the clone command. It's just slash clone, right? And then you target the block, so let's start with this one, slash clone, and then just tap completed, like that. So you pick one corner of your build, and then go to the other corner of your build. Make sure every block you want to clone is inside this region you are specifying, so go to the other corner of your build, and then re-get your, well, your command you just had, add this coordinate, like this. Now you've got two coordinates, you've specified this, you can now remove that block if you have any other blocks. And then go to a random place in your world, and then make sure that you know that which side is positive X and which side is positive Z. I'll underline it where it says that. And that means your build is going to appear right here. Right? So where there's positive X and positive Z. And positive Y, of course. So if we want to clone it over to here, we just look at this block, then complete the command, press enter, and it will be right here. That's all there is to it. It will, as you can see, clone the sign with the text on it. And if you go inside, it will also clone the chests with everything what that's in it. There's like nothing it can clone except for entities. So if you have any armor stands or minecarts, it won't clone those, right? Next, we've got a few command blocks to show you the different, things you can do with the slash clone command. First, it's just the normal clone command, right? But then with a command block, I've set it over to this block right here, which is broken, and the house, which is the 5x5 area over there, should be cloned just over there. There we go. That's the house. Same thing as I just showed you before. And down here it says I cloned 168 blocks. I think the maximum is around 32,000 blocks, and this includes air blocks. So be aware of that there is a limit to it. Next, there is this, which looks pretty complicated. Actually, it isn't complicated. It's just after the command you have filtered, and then a type of block, right? This time we have dark oak logs. If we press this button, you can see it only copies the dark oak logs from our original build. And you can change this to anything you like. So let's, well, next add, I don't know, the birch planks. And it also only shows you the blocks are that are in the original build. So only the button. I mean, at least I think so. It's a bit weird because some of the blocks are actually in my build, but some of them aren't, as you can see. Let's try planks. I think it's planks, right? Yeah, there we go. Let's filter every type of plank. Here we go, and there we go, we added the planks. And then we can also add the birch logs, and just complete the house like this in steps. I don't know why you want to do this, but it can be very helpful, right? So now you can do it step by step. After that, we've got masked move. So it's two different things, right? First of all, there's mask, which means that you copy only non-air blocks, so all the air blocks aren't copied, which is not really needed for this one, but I wanted to do that. And after that we have move. You can also do replace here. It would in this case have the same effect, because there are, in our destination area, there are no things that can interfere with the air block. So move just means it moves it. So after copying it, it will remove the original one. So if I press this button, you will see that the original build gets moved to over here. And I just put this button here to put it back. As you can see, the door and the bed pop off over here, but they are still in the original build, right? So it isn't really gone. This way you can move builds. I don't know if you wanted that, but that's also one of the clone command features. Next, we've got, you can't clone a build if the source is with destination, the source and destination areas cannot overlap, right? So I wanted to clone this cross over here, this block, which you can't do because it's the same in the same place, right? But we actually can do it if we do this replace, which is the normal thing, and then add force, which means you force it to clone. So it will always clone even if the areas overlap. Next, we've got masked again to show you the features of what it really is. And I forgot my button. We've got a button now, and now you can see that it will only take the non-air blocks over here. There we go. It added the granite into the diorite, but not any of the air blocks around it. Which is actually pretty helpful if you have a big build you want to clone, and because you only have the limit, you have the limit of 32,000 blocks, so without air it's always a lot less. So yeah, that was the clone command. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you now know how to use it, and I want to see you in the next video. So until then, bye bye! Oh, 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 oh